And welcome to Season 2 of Challenger League. Day 1, Week 1, the first stream in the new year for this league. I'm very excited. I'm your host, Sinju, and with me is Dracula. Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to Season 2 of Challenger League. I'm really happy to be back. I'm really happy that we're doing this together again, and I'm really looking forward to this new season and for all the players who are participating.
Yeah, so for the people that don't know us, my nickname is Sinju. I'm your host for today. Last season I took third place for KOF 98 UMFE, and Dracula took second place, kicked me out of the semifinals, which I didn't like.
That happened, I guess.
But yeah, KOF 98 today. Tomorrow we'll continue with Guilty Gear and so on. We'll let you know later. And yeah, I am very excited to see what the KOF 98 players have to offer, because it's always, you know, in German we say ranknallen. It's always a pleasure to watch KOF, and yeah. We have some new faces, we have some old faces, like yeah. The two of us, and let's have a look at the matches that the first match, and the first match will be RNGesus versus Mado 58. 8888888, and so both German players. RNGesus took fourth place last season. Mado didn't participate in season one, but he's a known German Tekken player. He also plays KOF 11 here in Frankfurt, so he is definitely used to playing KOF.
Yeah, definitely. And he improved over the years, especially in 11. And he's no slouch. He's pretty new to 98, as far as I know. And let's see how he will hold up against RNGesus. Because like RNGesus did very well last season and has a specific playstyle. And let's see if Mado can adapt to it. Because, like, if you're not that known in 98, I think it can be a real big problem. And we will see it in the replay sooner or later.
Yeah, so let's talk about the team composition, the characters that both players pick. So yeah. RNGesus plays the same team as last season. The Geese. He is the Geese. Right. He puts the Geese in his RNGesus nickname, yeah. And regular Mary and EX Yuri. Yes. So
very strong characters in general, and I think even like the composition in itself is pretty solid as well. Like the normal composition he plays is like Geese, Mary, and then Yuri, and I think this composition works really well, because like Geese. The way he plays Geese is very basic, and he doesn't need much meter to do a lot of damage. And his main goal was always to like get you in the corner and space you out with pretty much with a double Repuken
to push himself away.
So he and building a lot of meter in the process. So I think this is still pretty valid, and especially after the other two characters like Mary. It's very, very dangerous if she has meter. She doesn't need it especially, but if she has meter, it's really dangerous. Hmm. Not only for punishes, but for like neutral as well, because like reversal anti-air super is really good, and the situation afterwards is really good as well. So
she also has the one frame grab. So it's always like if you stand next to her, is it the command grab? Is she doing the DP, the DP super? I guess Geese doesn't really have good reversal options. Yuri, kind of the same, but with Mary, she's always dangerous, no matter the situation. Yeah. And especially against, I feel especially against the team that Mado is playing. I smell trouble for Mado, because Daimon and Rugal are kind of slow, and Daimon got kind of nerfed to regular Caref 98.
Like yeah, the he's Neo no Geo go anymore, yeah.
And Yashiro, I think Yashiro is fine. I think that should be the best character against these very agile, mobile characters that can, yeah, kind of keep just stay away or put projectiles on the screen like Geese and Yuri. It's very tight getting in against those two. Mm. And you kind of need to know what to do. And Yashiro, I feel, has just very, very good jump-ins to stop you from throwing projectiles.
Yeah.
Or you just take the gap. You just see the gap, you jump in, and then you have your turn, as you say in fighting game terms.
Definitely. I would say, I think Rugal is the worst character in this team and the most hardest to play, in my opinion.
Mm.
And especially if I see like the lineup against the other characters, it can be really hard. Especially, I think, against Mary and against Yuri. And maybe Geese as well, but we will see. One thing we didn't talk about much is that that Mado plays regular Yashiro, not EX Yashiro. That's a big difference, in my opinion. One thing he will be lacking is a good reversal, even though he has a guard point DP.
Mm-hmm.
But I think in terms of range and in terms of mobility, I'm definitely in your favor. I would say he's definitely up against this team. Daimon, on the other hand, yeah, he got nerfed a lot. He's not the god anymore like he's used to. But I think the simple button and poking game is fitting for Mado, and I think you don't have to ask, shouldn't underestimate the counter hit damage in this game. Like, you don't have always to do combos and punish things, but big counter hit hits do a lot of damage as well, and I think this is going to be like very interesting against this team. But we will see. I don't want to over-analyze this stuff. We will see it in the end. But I think it's gonna be tough, but not impossible, in my opinion.
Then I would say let's have a look. Let's see who took it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna start the video. Let's switch. So we got RNGesus player one side, and we got Mado player two side. Ping looks decent.
Yeah. Let's see. Unfortunately, we don't have the rollback netcode for this game. So if SNK or somebody looks at it, please patch it. We would really love it. But let's see. I hope they have a stable connection so far. Maybe you can skip a little bit. So one major change in Season 2 as well for the Challenger League. We are not live anymore, unfortunately, because we had technical difficulties. So we are watching a replay of the games. But I think the quality will speak for itself.
Yeah, it's going to be much better. Last season we had some trouble with the video and audio quality. But I think this now is much better. So at least you can enjoy good matches. You can actually see what's happening. So,
yeah.
But let's get into the game. Match 1. RNGesus starts with the Geese. Mado with the Rugal. Let's see
what's open is. Let's go, Season 2. And like I thought it would be, it's a double Pukin time already.
On the road through, okay!
Good roll, but no real punish. And he gets trapped again. Mado already lost 60% of his life.
Yeah, no meter build
and
up
he's
yet.
All, yeah, ooh. Nice OTG throw. And RNG is already looking like he's playing after Season 1. Already in the game.
Yeah.
Double Pukin everywhere. Yep. And the anti-air.
With RNGesus, you really saw the progression last season. At first, he just did the double Rep Pukin. And he kind of won through that, but then he kind of got better. He knows, like, against the strong players, he can't just do the double rear pukins all day, and started, yeah, kind of mixing up his playstyle. It's nice to see then that people improve over the weeks of Challenger League.
Yeah. But still on top in this match. Mado trying to get in. He had some good moments so far, but he gets clipped by the rear wave.
Ooh, and the double rear pukin again.
Yeah. And that's it. Looking pretty obvious for RNGs so far. Will he take the first OCP in this season? We will see.
Yeah, first match of the season and an OCP right away. That is that would be a statement. I have to be honest.
Yeah. But Mado not giving up, trying to get out of the corner, but gets
blocked
again. Oh, no punish after the roll.
Free punish, but just dodges away. Yeah. 3 meters and there's... What? How did he block it?
That was smart by Mado, not pressing a button there. Because one thing that is pretty unusual in KOF is that you can, if you neutral jump or back jump, you can still block. And he did that, but unfortunately, the first game and the first OCB in this season, number 2.
But why? Why could he block the super while falling down? Like, what? I totally expected him not to be able to block it. I know. Back jump and neutral jump, you can block, but
you can block if you don't press a button.
Yeah, of course, but who does press a button? Who doesn't press a button in KOF 98?
Yeah. Some Mado people.
Does. match.
So already weird interaction in this first game, but already good performance by RNGesus. Let's see if Mado can step it up.
That's why you should watch every week. It's KOF 98.
Yeah.
Shit is gonna go down. This game just does whatever it wants.
Yeah.
And Mado, cross.
Oh! Yeah, but no re combo. That's unfortunate.
Doesn't get the knockdown, jump CD.
Yeah.
Expected the. He has some projectile to reflect.
Yeah.
Oh, and the loads!
Nice confirmed by RNGesus.
That's
Ruger out of the picture. One thing I noticed so far is that Mado is playing good neutral, but his punches are not on point so far.
Yeah, it's one thing you're not allowed to do in KOF 98. You can't just leave the damage on the table. That's what makes a good player, I feel. Not just playing good neutral, but also getting the maximum damage whenever you have the chance.
Yeah, that's definitely it. Maybe he's not used to the
input engine.
Input engine of N98 because it's kind of special. Not like the other games, especially if you come from 11.
Oh, but
apart. Nice jump in. Good stuff by Mado. We are already seeing some adaption.
Yeah.
And also Yashiro staying hydrated in the other way.
Oh, okay. Nice read on the slide. RNGesus really likes to do the Mary slide.
Yeah, but unfortunately no real punish by Mado. He can do like crouching C into other stuff there.
If she's so close. If it's not zoned correctly. Oh! Anti-air super.
In the last frame. Nice one by RNGesus. Both still playing like respectful neutral.
That's break a leg.
Good thing. The overhead after the knockdown. Hard knockdown. Good stuff by RNGesus so far. We only feel like there's like some small stuff that Mado can do different. And he could like definitely get some stuff.
Yeah.
But let's see if it's still possible to turn it around. So far, RNG is in the lead. Missing his jump in. Getting clipped, but no recovery.
Got a blocked low. It's a low.
No.
Counter? Was that the counter super?
No, no, it was a regular F-track move.
Ah!
But they fucked up. Oh!
Just rolled through.
Yeah. Oh!
Ramp out.
Ah!
Ah!
And the double
over hits.
Takes the D. Ooh, nice one, like, and Jesus.
I totally expected Mado to just block. And Jesus was down. He was so low on HP. He had 2 meters, could have got cancelled, but man. Yeah, two overheads in a row. Who does that? Where's the mix-up? Oh shit, I need to ban somebody.
Yeah.
Alright, so match number 3. Let's see, no team changes. So Ruka first, same team order for Mado. Also no. No change for him, Jesus.
Yeah, still already 2-0 in the lead. First. Yep, no change.
A Rippuken.
Yeah.
That's also a Rippuken.
Mm-hmm.
It looks different.
The battle of
same move.
The battle of a Rippuken, yes.
Yeah. Ah,
Warcraft, no refund.
But it's okay.
Yeah. Mm.
Oh, oh, you hate to see it. You got the read, yeah, but. You got a bad entire.
Yep.
Ah! Under pressure! Invincible! Dizzy? Okay.
And he was dizzy as well. That was unfortunate. And he got shit out.
No meter.
That's kind of the thing to happen. The thing was, like, you can see, like, a little bit of desperation playing by Mado. He did a lot of stuff on Wake Up, which wasn't, like, safe or good at all. He gets clipped a lot.
Ah, now the cross! You had it! I think he pressed. Like, you mentioned the KOF 11 gameplay, and I think he does a lot of jumping A because of the long hits done in 11.
Yeah.
But nope.
Especially if you press it too early, you can still, like, hit stuff, but that's not the thing in 98. You have really. To press it really as late as possible.
Yeah.
And especially hard moments if it's possible.
Yeah.
Because the hit stun varies very much. So.
Another double Rippuken.
Yeah. Mado in a big pickle, already losing 60% of his life.
Hey, Kumar grab! Okay, dash it! Another one? No.
Yeah. Missed his. Missed his. His punch as well, but he's still in the corner. One command curve,
oh,
second
command
curve.
Oh, did
you riff? Yeah, Antea.
Mado vaults into... Oh, another command grab! Okay.
Another command grab, yeah. You cannot stand beside Diamond and try to meet him. He will always, or always wins with a command grab. So you have to be prepared for that. You have to bait that. But I think Jesus doesn't need to do that because, like, he has full Mary and full Yuri still on board, and Mado is already bleeding. Ah, bad read, bad punish. And.
Dude, that's not how you commentate!
3-0 already for Jesus.
Dracula! What do you say? Bad read, bad punish! It's just Jesus playing very smart. He knows, okay, Mado, he respects me a lot. That's a lot of respect. He doesn't want to press buttons. He respects my reversals. That's it is just conditioning, you know? It's just conditioning.
Yeah.
That's what's happening.
You can put it like that.
Yeah, and also I just read the chat, Sonic saying, I didn't expect to see Genocide Cutter being used as an anti-air.
Yeah,
that describes the move as
maybe against full jumps, but not against hops. It's too slow for that. But let's see. Already fourth game, Jesus in the 3-0 lead. And what we saw in the last matches is Geese doing it his work. Double Pugan, a lot of missed opportunities by Mado. Maybe it was changed in the fourth match. Already in the mid-swing game, but Ruga already lost like 70% of his health. Oh, hitting, but what was that? Yeah.
Ah, it's unblockable, you gotta jump! Knowledge checks.
Yep.
Oh, expected the double rep again.
Yeah. But also bad punish by Jesus, but doesn't care. Still gets.
He still won! Doesn't matter!
It doesn't matter!
Yeah, it doesn't matter! You just gotta win! You can't punish perfectly all the time. If you do that, then you will just drop stuff. So.
Yeah, just keep calm and do a double repooking, I guess.
Okay, double repooking. JKN can't punish this.
Yeah, that's pretty tight punish. Nice. DP.
Daddy Red Block!
Red Block?
Oh, no! No, you have so much time!
You can do crushing C. But one thing that Joshua accessed is. Oh, not again! One thing that Joshua can do is like crushing C into forward A. The thing is, crushing C is pretty fast and pretty big from the hitbox. But.
Rehydrating.
Doesn't care. Yeah, he staying hydrated.
That's how you recover health.
Stay hydrated in the chat.
That's how you recover health in KOF. Rehydrating.
Yeah. It's important.
And
let's get back.
CD? Overhead. Oh, come on! All the overheads. RNG's. Jesus.
Yeah.
That guy, he loves his. Do I do the overhead mix up? But with Mary, well, you can do it, especially with regular Mary, because her overhead doesn't knock down. Oh, come on! Iron Jesus! Man, this read. And super confirm. Very nice. Nice.
Very big damage down. And also a good situation afterwards.
Again, overhead. Third one!
Yeah. If a second doesn't hit, do another one. And just go in and throw. That's pretty clean play. Oh, not clean play. Pretty good play by Iron Jesus.
Unfortunate for Mado. I think he was trying to wiggle guard. So you keep. No, he was not. He was not teabagging. He just wanted to keep being throw invincible.
Yeah.
But
if you change your position from crouching to standing, your throw hitbox disappears for a short amount of time,
also,
and you cannot get hit by command grabs.
Yeah, he wanted to block and then wiggle, but he got hit, so he never got into the blocking animation.
Yes.
But it was a good try.
Yeah.
Alternate guard.
That's pretty, that's the name of the.
Wiggle.
Heck.
I call it the wiggle. The wiggle guard.
Oh, and we got a change. Fifth game of the set, and Mado trying something different. Putting Yashori at first, which is okay, but I think Yashori with Nita is a little bit better. Nice. No real jump after that. And also looking a little bit better. One thing that I don't like about Mado's gameplay is he's poking a little bit
not enough.
Yeah, not invincible. And he gets clipped again for the bad roll.
Yeah,
one thing I noticed a lot is he doesn't poke a lot, like he tries to jump in a lot, and this is not that good, especially against Geese. I think you should stop some of his attempts with at least a far B or something different.
I think jumping in is okay, but you need to jump after the first double rep hit.
Yeah, definitely.
So you against Geese, you really have to use the gaps, like you said. And it's looking like RNGesus working on an OCB in the fifth match as well.
Yeah, to make it a perfect 5-game streak.
You know one thing? I just noticed one thing. With Daimon, you can just do the ground pound, right? Against the double rep Pukin.
If you will, yes.
Yeah, if you just keep your spacing. Because RNGesus does it pretty far away sometimes. Outside, I don't know if Kaiserway is a super for regard.
It's just a normal special.
So it would disappear against the Repuken.
Yes.
Okay. It depends on the property, right? It could be super property. But it's okay. Yeah. So RNGesus, pretty big life lead. Oh, had to confirm,
the
too far away.
But still looking good for RNGesus.
Oh, and there's the deadly rave!
And the deadly rave,
and
very active.
Seals the deal. So RNGesus 5-0. poor street performance. Geez.
Yeah. First performance of the season. And yeah, you can see like the inexperience from Mado. I think the analysis of this match is pretty clear. Mado played okay neutral, even though I think he missed a lot of opportunities to like poke. And the second thing I would say is his punishes went off on point. Like, he had a lot of opportunities to punish, but it wasn't like on point. Like, I think he didn't even know what to do most of the time. So if I would give him advice for the next or for the whole season, I would say work on your punishes and work on your poking game. I think these are the two things I think that could improve him a lot. And
yeah, he had the right reads. Like he counterplayed right geese pretty well. A lot of rolls worked. He also did the guard cancel roll on the first hit, but yeah, like you said, he just left the damage on the table. You need to punish. If you get the opportunity to punish, the animation is very long of the double rip hooking. It's just very good on block if you block the second hit. So yeah, but to be honest, I was very pleasantly surprised that he could counterplay geese that well. Sometimes it didn't. Well, you had OCBs, but you know, some players just crumbled completely because they just keep blocking and blocking, and then they get chipped out. So yeah, it was a good performance by Mado, I have to say.
Yeah. It's even though the result was pretty high, like 5-0 is no slouch. I think he has definitely potential and room for improvement. Maybe, like I said, improve on these two things and try to improve on them, and maybe he still has a chance to qualify for the top four. Because this time around, we only have one group. Top four will advance to the playoffs. And I think he is still a candidate, but he has to play a lot, he has to improve a lot. But it's not an impossible task. And maybe it's still possible for him. But still, good shit to Jesus as well. I don't want to downplay him.
Yeah, good confirms. He checked the knowledge if it works. And you saw the confirms. So I have to say, Jesus also improved a lot during the last season. If I compare this match to the first matches of season one by Iron Jesus, you saw a lot of a lot more adaption, more mix up, and yeah. So if somebody's improving throughout the season and somebody comes in totally new, I know Mado has experience in KOF 11, but of course you gotta kind of get some experience in the game first as well. Yes. So, okay, then you mentioned the bracket. Let's have a quick look. We don't have any results yet. So you can actually see who is playing in 98. So Iron Jesus is gonna be first place because he won his match. And you got me, Paladin, Mesh Hades is back again. So Paladin also returning, Mesh Hada returning. Heiko, the current champion that came out of nowhere and stomped everyone. Mr. Mantis, did he play last season?
Yes, he played last season. He was in the B group, didn't make it out of the pools. Mm. But also German new player, and as far as I know, he's the training partner of Iron Jesus, as far as I know. Pretty solid player as well. Let's see if he can play again and how he plays, especially because I know he plays the casuals against Iron Jesus a lot. And let's see if he has some new stuff. I'm sorry, I have to correct myself. He was in my pool in Group A. We had to play. But yeah, we will see.
Yeah, if you like Rugal, then you should watch his matches. Because he's also playing Rugal. Definitely.
Yeah.
Then we have Dracula. Invitation pending.
Back again.
He's not in KOF 15. He didn't accept the invitation. Dracula is not part of that game. Itokaru also a new face, which we are going to see in a moment. And then Mado 8-8-8-8-8. The 5-8s.
Yes.
Too many eights. Too many eights.
Okay.
So let's before we go into the second match, just a quick shout out to our supporters, sponsors, Kata Games, which again provide mousepads for 3 winners, and we are gonna raffle one. So keep an eye on our Twitter. We're gonna raffle one away. You just have to follow us and retweet probably. And then we have the Matcherino. We also have the links below the stream. You can just click the link, enter the code, and that way you can add 25 US dollar cents to the prize pool. And you can also do the sponsor quests to add even more to the prize pool. So we would appreciate if you could do that. And with Kata Games, if you cannot wait for the raffle, if you want your mouse pad right now, you can use the code 2BCU10 and you get 10% off on the mouse pads. We also have a button below, so if you need the link, it's katagames.shop. But there's also a button below the stream and you can just click it.
And
also, we got prizes by SNK for both KOF games, which
thanks
we
again.
We don't know what we're going to receive yet, but last season we had a pile of t-shirts. We had some nice clear foils for paper. And what do we also have?
The first place got a special printout.
Oh, yeah, the picture. Yes. The Brian picture. I remember.
Yeah, for Heiko, and it was well deserved because I think Brian was the best character in the grand finals. You saw that a lot.
Yeah.
And big thanks to SNK again. I hope that's not 98 related. I hope you get maybe some 15 stuff, like some stickers or something.
Oh,
I'm really, really looking forward to that. But big thanks, especially to Crispy Kaiser. I hope he's watching the stream. Big shout outs to him as well, because SNK, even though it's not the biggest company, always supports even the smallest scenes. So I really appreciate that. So big thanks to SNK again.
Yeah, of course, big thanks to all our
All our sponsors.
Supporters.
I'm just a little bit biased for SNK, so.
Yeah, you're a fanboy.
Yeah. Kinda, sorta.
Yeah. So okay. let's have a quick look at the second match. As promised, Itokaru is playing against Paladin. So we have one familiar face in Paladin from last season, one new face, Itokaru, and look at that team. Okris, Benny Maru, and I think it was EX Rio, not regular Rio. So it's 3 very, very strong characters, especially I wanna see. Is he playing advanced meter or is he playing the extra meter? Because with EX Rio, extra meter is better. I guess with the other two it's advanced. It's probably the advanced meter that's better. But let's see. So it's a strong team. So if he plays well, he can definitely take this. This is no sandbag team. That's what I want to say.
Definitely not. The matchup in both teams is pretty equal in my opinion. Paladin is pretty good with Leona, so I think this is one character we will see, especially in this match. And also one thing I notice is that each team has like one archetype of character in it. Like we got the Zona character, we got the character which can do a lot of damage with meter, and we got the character who is very mobile. And I think this is on paper, like if you see it like that, it's pretty equal. So it's going to be interesting. I think like the experience is going to make it. And I'm really hoping for Paladins Leona, because like not only in the Challengers League, but also in the Community Cup, he did pretty well with Leona. And it was, in my opinion, my most favorite character to watch from Paladin. Let's see if we see some good ass Leona action in this game as well. Because like Leona is pretty unpopular in 98 at least. And I'm really always seeing like, I'm really hyped to see like Leona specialist in this game, because like if you play the character, it's also like a specialist character, I think.
Yeah, I think so as well. Like with Leona, it's a bit of a different playstyle you gotta play. She's not typical like Shoto character. You got a lot of Shoto type characters in 98. So yeah, she's a bit special, but especially her V slasher is very dangerous. So if she has one meter, you really need to pay attention what you're doing,
because you don't want to drop too much. Yeah,
you don't want to throw stupid fireballs full screen, or you get V slashed. And yeah, with King and Kyo, also two characters that can. Well, King can stay out, but Kyo, he's all Oonga Boonga. He's gonna ape. He's gonna jump down C all day. And that's what he likes to do, so you gotta keep him from that. But last time I played with Mantis, he also plays Kyo, and he was like, with Kyo, either I steamroll or I just die without doing anything. And that's the risk of the character. He wants to go in, and you gotta take risks. You gotta take risks to get in. So sometimes you just blow up with the cure.
Definitely. And on the other side, we have Ocris, who has like similar gameplay. If you don't cross up or don't anti-aim him as well, you can get a lot of damage as well. So let's see. I think enough talking. I think it's time for the gameplay. So, second match, Paladin against Etokaru. Scotland against Germany again.
Oh, yeah, I have to switch the flag.
Yeah. Please do in the meantime. In the meantime, I will commentate. So, on the left side, we have Paladin, and on the right side, we have Etokaru. Already selecting both characters and both playing in the advanced mode, so the question which mode we play is out of the window, and we have one mistake or like one big change. I don't know if it's intentional, but I see a Kenzo instead of an Ocris. So two zoners in Etokaru's favor. It wasn't intentional, okay. But still playing, okay, so let's see. Second match of the second season is starting already. Both trying to poke each other out. And nice anti-air by Etokaru so far. And the play of Paladin is beginning with the Venom Strikes.
Etokaru really likes the dive kicks, it seems. Dive kick and fireball. But EX King doesn't need to respect it with full screen projectiles. Also good anti-ass. EX King in general, very strong character. Standing CD, it whiffs! that's the thing with the super, it tends to whiff in 98 UMFE.
God crush air block. One nice thing to see, nice take by Tokaru so far. And even though the game was pretty slow, both playing pretty easily so far. Not as demo like in the last game, in the last set.
This is a character we did not have in the picture. We have Ocris is now cancelled.
Yeah. So this happened. And Paladin already making his way into the corner. Oh, nice adaption on the Rift DP.
I'm taking a lot of risks. Let's see if he does definitely. The DP again.
Mm-hmm. This interesting air to air. And right now he tries to zone but gets clipped by the super.
Yeah, super projectile just flying through the regular projectiles. And that's it.
And, yeah, and the proximity unblockable into trap shot seals the deal. A lot of damage, especially in the corner. That's really dangerous with AX King as well. But she gets a lot of it. Oh, and startup DP. He was believing on the jumping from Paladin.
The slides in this game. Slides are so strong, it's so difficult to punish them, even with the jumping. Yeah. Oh, that's... Ooh. Yeah, just... he just rambles away!
No punish, oh my god. I think he tried to close C into something else, but they didn't came out. That can happen.
We got the zoning, air projectors. EXVO can do it.
Yeah, but he has to be careful. But not anymore, because King is out of the picture. So no OCV in the second set so far.
And now it's gonna be much more difficult for Paladin. Because Kyo, that Rio DP, ADP, that DP is something else, I gotta say.
Yeah. Definitely.
Tokaro
and
not,
Tokaro again in the corner.
Not playing the advantage of the Rio at the moment. Not just zoning with the projectiles, actually letting in Paladin. Jump down C. Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, reset into throw.
Yeah, with a hit. After a hit, you don't have the throw invincibility. So you can just dash in and then throw right away.
Yeah, and that's it.
Let's see if we have any changes from Metakaru. And now we got the Ocress and the EX Rio. So now Kenzo drop right away.
And one interesting thing to see that Metakaru isn't playing Ocress on the anchor position, which is pretty popular with Ocress. He's already playing him on the second position.
Maybe
he's more in the zoning game, more confident in the zoning game with Rio. But we will see. Already Paladin, pretty strong start with EX King. Already got Etoko in the corner and applying his pressure. Still, Etoko has no answer so far. Interesting interaction with the dive kick. But still, no big damage from Etoko. Don't reconfirm from Paladin either. But he doesn't care because he already did a lot of damage.
Paladin can't get him a lot of stray hits, but every combo.
Yeah. But sometimes this is enough. That's one thing that makes 98 a little bit different, but the poking game is pretty strong as well. So you don't only have to rely on big combos.
Yeah, one good counter hit can take off like 15%. So, depending on what you're hitting with.
Yeah, and not even that, you can even like change your momentum if you do it right. So this time, no Kenzo, Ocris in town, but still getting open up.
Ooh, activation, okay.
Yeah. Because he knows he doesn't get a lot of combos, so he trying to get the big hit, because if you activate max mode you get more damage for the single hits, but more pushback as well, so this is a trade-off. And so far Itoko having a lot of trouble not getting in a lot, pressing a lot of buttons as well, like in the neutral.
Like,
doesn't seem to approach much. And he's getting clipped. Yeah, good punish.
Yeah, Paladin is playing it very smart though. He's always in this range where Etokaru needs to press something. And he saw that Etokaru tends to use the specials that are kind of punishable, very high commitment So yeah, you just stand in range and punch.
Yeah.
Playing it safe with the projectiles like you saw. Dashing in, but going right out. Right out of range.
Yeah, you can see that he's pretty not confident with his character so far. Had him in full control. Nice command grab. And again, only communities.
Oh,
no
okay.
DP as well.
Oh, CDP. Not blocked.
Put that punish. Oh, double strike.
Oh, I have Shokoken hits. Okay.
Yeah.
Ah, a bit too late. Another Hao Shokoken gets thrown through.
Ooh,
not dead yet.
That's
ah, that's not what you want. That's not what you want.
And already 2-0 for Paladin.
No, it's not what you want with full screen, the C version.
Yeah.
Of Underskin.
Yes, of the classic, of the Staubsauger, of
the
vacuum cleaner.
The special move actually has uses, so it's not. You can actually combo out of a hard punch into it, it has hard knockdown. So EX3O gets the free OTG air fireball. So if you hit with it, that's the best conversion you got.
Okay. So let's see if he can land it. But we have another change as well. No, it's still the same, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Same positions.
Had a bit of game in the set.
I don't understand the dive kicks. The jump D is good enough. You just spam the jump D. It does everything. It's the Swiss Army knife.
Pretty
it can
much,
cross.
Yeah.
It's air to air, it's air to ground.
Yeah. You can use it sometimes to like change your timing with the jump in and bait something like that. Like
but it does no damage. Look at the damage. It's just... But it's okay. It's okay,
it's
he
okay.
Probably has reasons to do it.
Good punish by Paladin as well. Ah, but not confirmed.
Whoa! Okay! Just teleporting forward again.
The last active frame, clipping King. But it doesn't care, like, Paladin is still in full control.
Yeah.
Even though he's in the corner right now. Ah, but the punish from the drill.
Just
that
do
happened.
The jump D. Just jump D. If you neutral jump, just D. What is he supposed to do? If he does do, like crouching C, he's just gonna trade. That's the best thing he got.
Yeah. So Paladin already got Itokar in the corner.
Throw.
No pace as well. That's one thing I noticed as well from Itokar. He doesn't
roll
tech so much. Even though he got a lot of opportunities for that.
Yeah, but it's... It's difficult in 98. I fuck it up as well. Just rolling on the knockdown, it just happens.
Yeah.
Ah, that's super. Oh no, punish!
Yeah. I think it was a misinput as well. Because that happens sometimes. And the jumping C taking Oakus out. And this looks like the last match. Put it in full control. Yes. Full range of his moveset. He's adapting. Like, it's really nice to see. Nice cross under.
Ah, you don't do it in neutral! The Rambu!
Yeah.
Not with Ryu!
Don't do the Rambu.
It doesn't have any invincibility. Just, in this matchup, just air fireball. You're doing the right thing, Etokaru. Just air fireball, ground fireball.
Yeah.
And ADP. You don't do CDP, do ADP. ADP is much better.
Yeah. Ooh, bad
sweep. You could have got it! just crouching C! Just to enter S, that's it! And to Karu, oh, gets thrown! 3-0 for Paladin.
Yep.
This is very unbiased commentary at the moment. Just for info. there's no bias. I don't know that guy. He's German.
Yeah.
I'm German. I don't know that. I don't know that guy. Why would I root for him? I don't know.
Yeah, no bias. But we have to. I have to say, Paladin is AX King looking very clean.
Yeah.
Like one thing, but what we didn't commentate was that used their slides against the air fireball from Rio to get under and punish him after that, so it was really, really good.
Now,
so one thing we have to say, like, Paladin plays very clean in the set so far. And I don't think it's going to change much. And we see a change as well from Etokaro's side. He's playing Kenzo at first.
Yeah.
So maybe he tries to at least zone King out, if it's possible. So let's see. Ah, no punish from the tornado kick.
Oh, did he get? Okay.
Anti-air, yeah. And now the fireball game begins.
Just zone.
Yeah.
It's fine, that's how you play Kenzo. You have a team that is two-thirds zoner, you don't go in. Just throw fireballs and you're good. No jump bombs! What are you doing? What's the read there?
Not really, I think he's trying to set some kind of pace. But it doesn't work out. But kinda. Like, this is the most equal match we have so far. But, have no fear. Expert in the sphere. Gets with proximity into third shot, that's a lot of damage. And also, Paladin already has like fully stocked and full in control.
Yep. Almost chipped!
Yeah, and accidental misinput by Itokaru, and he gets to play the black guy.
That was definitely.
Yeah, definitely. That happens sometimes. If you press forward and miss one button press, you get sometimes. Command moment, and that sucks sometimes.
So let's have a look. Super Meteor, Paladin, 3 stocks, Ocris, Itokaru, 2 stocks. So we can see some guard cancels, we can see some supers.
Yeah.
And
That's not important so far.
He just can't get out of the corner. He gets into the corner and Paladin keeps a safe. Same spacing, so he won't get hit by the DPs. So he takes reverse DPs out of the out of the equation, and it's just Paladin plays the corner game very, very cleanly at the moment.
Yeah, he doesn't go too aggressive as well, so he's trying to switch things up, trying to like keep his distance. So that's a really good thing to see from Paladin. It's not just like. The difference in the level is different in playing as well, so nice thing to see. Nice idea with our Shokunon, but it was the slow version. I think he has the Fadi. He's still in full control, even though he has lost a lot of life. Good roll, good punish so far, no meter use. Guter Ware. But still, Paladin in full control. Weird detection. And he gets killed by the House of Token. So maybe this is a little turn up for Etokaru, who knows?
It's not over yet, yeah.
It's not over yet. So it could possibly.
Like I said, Kyo can. Oh, okay, that's not how you suicide Kyo. Just getting the counter hit, RADK.
Yeah.
Adi. Ah, no! Oh, I was so close!
Oh, no Shinagi. Okay, that's interesting. No Shinagi,
that's closing
well.
Out!
Two opportunities.
But now there it is, standing B.
There it is. The 4-0 so far. Even though he dropped 2 opportunities, he still gets the kill. Paladin.
Yeah, he probably just didn't expect the up kicks to hit because the normal was blocked. And then the up kicks hit. And then you're like, what am I supposed to do? And then you just try to do the DP real quick. Because the red kick you gotta do right away after you launch when you don't have the time to react, or you need to really good reactions to react to that situation this quickly.
Yeah definitely.
So now match point for Paladin, just needs to take one more. It's first 5. But it's okay, it's a round robin system, so we're gonna see more of Itokaru even if he loses today.
Yeah.
Just for your info, we're gonna see more of him next week. He's on stream again. We're gonna have 3 matches next week.
Yeah. But let's concentrate on this match. And it looks kind of same like the last form it took. Etoka was still in the corner. And Paladin in full control with the Ken. Nice confirmation low. Doesn't roll. And again. Just with crushing B into pro. Taking the opportunity.
Yeah, but if the B hits, no throw invincibility, just go in and then throw him. I mean, but if the opponent respects you a lot, doesn't press a lot of buttons, then you can just, do it. It's just conditioning.
Yeah. A nice jump, even though it wasn't a big combo.
My god,
it's still big enough for Paladin.
Unblockable.
Yeah. Bam. A lot of damage. Fully stocked. Lows, but no trap shot. Delayed. Venom strike into Fuzzy. That takes a deal. And I think we will look at OCV. Last game, an OCV, that would be a strong, strong end for the set for Paladin.
Yeah, but look at the life. That king is really, really healthy. Etoka really trying to get in.
Yeah.
No slides though. Oh, it's doing this hop special.
Yeah.
Oh, super hits! Alright!
Random Hooper, but it hits, so it counts. Bad anti air, but big damage by Paladin so far.
Yeah, not one more. Oh, super
attack. That's close out. Nice. So this is one thing here, it's possible you can do the proximity unblockable and end it with a Venom Strike super. And he did that, and that was a good close to the set. Yeah. And a very strong close for Paladin. So we didn't see Leona at all. We only saw some Kyo and mostly the X-King, so congrats to him. It was a very obvious and clean play, definitely. So Paladin didn't need to change anything. If he plays like this in the other games, I think he has a good chance of qualifying. Etoka on the other side, you can see the inexperience, like in a lot of his decisions and his playstyle. Seemed pretty random so far to me. It isn't like I don't want to shit talk him or something, but you can see the inexperience so far. I hope he gets better. I hope he has fun and plays with team. I think it has potential.
They are strong characters, just more hopping, more aggressive playstyle, or like playing the Benimaru. I just felt that Jump D is such a good option. You can just Jump D and you can win matches just doing that move because it's so strong. So, I guess we saw a lot of full jumps. So I probably guess he has a regular fighting game background where you don't have hops. So where you only have full jumps, and then of course it's a bit difficult to do the hops. But you have to say the corner game that Paladin played was also very clean. You saw Etokaru trying to jump out, and Paladin just put the Pharisee on the screen, hitting him during the jump startup or during the first frames of the jump, so he couldn't get out. And then as somebody that isn't like, he probably has not played against the X-King. Maybe you're not used to the unblockables, the unblockable hits. And so in that case, you're like, what am I supposed to do? I block, I get unblockable. I try to jump out to evade the situation, I get hit. I try to DP, it gets baited, or like he's too far away. And then you're like, yeah, what am I supposed to do? And it's okay. Like, it's okay. You just have to practice a bit, get a bit more experience, like you say. A bit. I think with KOF, the thing is movement. You need a feeling for the movement. That's very important. It's probably the most important part, especially in 98. the movement and the poking play, the poking game style, how, when you need to poke, which buttons are good to poke with, and then you your skill level goes up very, very quickly when you have an understanding of this, or when you can do it.
Yeah.
Because that's
you have to get those the are feel, the basics. Yeah.
But yeah, I think all the players we saw, we had 2 5-0s today, but even the players that that got 5-0'd, Mado and Itokaru, I think they have potential. They just need to play a bit more, and then they can definitely take off matches of other players.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and let's talk about the rest of the week before we're going to talk about the matchups for next week, just for your information. So today was the first day, but we're going to stream until Thursday every day, 7:30 p.m. CET. So same time every day. And tomorrow we got Guilty Gear XR Draft 2. On Wednesday we got Undernight. And then on Thursday, if you like KOF, we got King of Fighters 2002 UM, which has the highest number of players with 38 yep. players. And so they are playing 4 matches. It's also going to be VODs like today. So it's going to be 4 matches on Thursday for KOF 02 UM. But I hope you're going to tune in every day, of course. And so back to us. Next week we got some... It's the rematches. It's the rematches of the grand final last season. We got Dracula versus Heiko. We got
yes.
We got the player. We got the third place decider match rematch. Sinchu versus RNGesus. So me against RNGesus. And we got Etokaru versus Mesh Hada. So we gonna have 3 games next week. Cause we would have to drop the Dracula vs Heiko match, I think, because Dracula is gonna have a lot of matches that are gonna be shown to have it to keep it balanced. But we cannot show this match or these matches, because these are the top 4 players from last season, and I guess RNGesus is out for revenge. Playing against me, and you're probably out for revenge playing Heiko. And this is gonna be nuts. This is gonna be insane. I'm so looking forward to seeing the matches. I guess we're gonna take turns casting, because you know the result of your match. I know the result of my match. So
I want to try at least to be as neutral as possible and maybe explain some of my
train of thoughts.
My thoughts, transitions and stuff. So we will see how we manage this next week. But it's definitely a very, very strong week next week, especially with the top 4 from last season. And Mesh Hada is also a very interesting player. He's, the honest guy in Spain, from Spain in this season.
Yeah, he is.
And one thing that I still remember is that he has a very... for a big variety of characters, so maybe we'll see this next week. But I think this matchup is maybe a little bit better for Etokaru than this match against Paladin, because even though Mesh Hada has a wide variety of characters, I think his level is okay. It's not like completely impossible to beat him, especially on Etokaru's level. But we will see. I think this is going to be a very interesting next week. Yeah. So I'm really looking forward to that, and I hope we can see some nice action next week as well.
Yeah, dude, we got these matches. It's gonna be the best action that we can show. The top 4 players, 3 matches in a row. It's gonna be crazy. We're gonna see a lot of crazy things. KRF98, it just does whatever it wants, and we have to deal with it. So it's going to be fun watching that. And Yeah, that's it. That's it for today. So you're gonna see me tomorrow again in Guilty Gear. I'm gonna cast with Koji tomorrow. And yeah, otherwise we are gonna see each other again on Monday for 98 casting. And,
yes.
But please tune in the other streams as well. We're gonna be live Tuesday. Well, Monday till Thursday for 10 weeks now. No, 9 weeks. Because we have the grand final weekend, the grand final Saturday. So it's 9 weeks, more than 2 months of matches every evening except Friday. And yeah, so I hope you're gonna enjoy this season. And that's it for today. Have a nice evening, guys, and
yeah.
See you on Monday.
Bye bye. Tune in next time.